Now, we are moving ahead to a very interesting fireside chat, and the topic would be the growing importance of news publishers as the era of third-party cookies comes to an end. And please allow me to introduce you to Mr. Puneet Jain, CEO for digital business HT Media Group, who comes with a unique combination of building large businesses from scratch, as well as advising large corporations in their journey to scale up. Extremely focused on execution and firmly believes that it's the implementation that makes any good idea a great success. And also, I would like to introduce you to now our session chair, Ms. Nazia Alvi Rahman, editor for Exchange for Media, to join us for this quick fireside chat with Mr. Puneet Jain.
Hey, hi, Nazia.
Hi. So we have already started. We are already running behind schedule. So first of all, welcome, Puneet, and thanks for doing this. And I'll straight away jump to the question so that I can have maximum out of this session from you. So, you know, the first question is, of course, about your journey. You know, we've been tracking HT Media's progress in last few years, and it's been an exciting journey. We've seen HT grow from a print giant to, you know, one of India's leading consumer internet houses. So, you know, while we all see your outcome, if you can take us through the journey, you know, if you can tell us how it has been, and you know, what have been the key drivers for your growth?
Sure. I think firstly, thanks, Nazia, for having me here. It's a pleasure to be part of this forum and to talk to you and your esteemed audiences. I feel fortunate. So you're right. I think last couple of years have been phenomenal for HT Digital. The kind of growth we have seen, and we have become in India some of the largest digital destination in the country. That's just outstanding, and I feel fortunate to be part of this journey. If I were to break this progress into three dimensions, I mean, that's how we typically benchmark ourselves on how we are growing. It is reach, engagement, and audience. Right. With respect to reach, I think we scaled from some 70 odd million to 190 million users over the last two and a half years, among the fastest growing players in the country in this period. Right. And I think it came on back of quite a few interventions. I think first and foremost, and I heard this from, I think, one of the panelists in the previous session, I think it's the realization of going a digital first approach. I think firstly, I think the importance and the leadership mandate towards building our digital first business. I mean, as soon as that sort of came in, and we built out the relevant team to drive that progress. I think what it has helped us to scale from some, we had about three platforms a few years back. Now at this point, we have 20 plus consumer platforms across genres, news and non-news, and which helps us to, let's say, push out credible news and engaging content day after day, right? I think what has further helped us is we have been able to, let's say, identify content niches. It was typically underserved, like health, tech, auto, food, and built engaging content formats to leverage the current consumer preferences from long form content, short form content, visuals, videos, right? Flip like news pieces, and lastly, I think building out the hyper personalized recommendations on our web and app platform. I mean, again, I'll just spend a few seconds on this hyper-personalization. I think over the last couple of years, we have significantly invested in our product and tech stack. And last year, we built our own AI tech stack, which probably makes us among the few publishers in the country right now to have its own in-house AI stack, which has helped us significantly personalize the content feed of every user. And as we, let's say, further improve our ability to collect and leverage data, this personalization will keep getting better and better, like adding on to the engagement part. I think we're also very bullish on the vernacular content. So over the last few years, we built out our Hindi and Bangla play and gained leadership in these segments. I think soon you will see us launching a few more languages and getting deep into the vernacular space. In fact, just last week, we launched our Telugu platform. Lastly, I think in terms of audience, in terms of enabling our advertisers to reach their audiences, and we are enhancing our customer data platform abilities and learning from experiments every day and investing heavily on data and tech to scale up our first party capabilities massively.
Thanks, Puneet. You just mentioned that how your focus is on developing your tech and first party data abilities. So, you know, given that news is one of the biggest categories accessed on the internet, do you think publisher partnerships are now even more important for brands? As we all know that third party cookies are coming to an end. And so are the news publishers prepared with alternatives for the eventual demise of third party cookies?
So I think first and foremost, I think all of us realize this, and all of us are very well aware that it's a very large event. The digital advertising space, which is probably as old as 20 years and more, right, globally and in India, has been cookie has been an integral part of user targeting and digital ad, and one of the key reasons for let's say the overall ROIs it was to deliver and the growth it has seen. Right. So one, it's a very large change for everyone involved in the value chain, the ecosystem, from brands on one side to publishers like us on the other side. It is a very, very large change. And all of us are sort of would need to figure our own ways of, let's say, dealing with it and capitalize on it. Right. I think the good part is sufficient time is being given to do this transition. So it's not an overnight transition, and it allows people to plan their strategies in post cookie world. I think as a publisher, as HT, we almost feel like it's sort of our second chance for and a chance for redeem ourselves. I think the digital boom came so fast that probably some of us and several of us sort of wasn't well prepared, but I think this time around is almost like a chance for how interest targeting will be done in future. And as publishers, it's an opportunity for us to know our consumers better and offer those insights to advertiser without probably any third party in between. So I think one, it's a very large opportunity, right? And I feel that all of us are getting there in working towards it. One part of the question was why publishers are, let's say, well-placed to do this. I think firstly, it's the scale. I mean, together we publishers attract about 500 million users every month on our news content that's as big as social media or any other digital destination out there in the country. Even at HT alone, we boast of 200 million users coming to our platform, right? So what I think we have been doing at HT is leverage our scale and increase our identified user base. So being able to identify our users, then subsequently driving the user registration and then moving them up in the overall journey of having knowing them better. And parallelly, we are building and optimizing our customer data platform so that we are able to capture all the content they are viewing, the topics they tend to be interested in, their response to various marketing campaigns, right? So if you see, there's a tremendous amount of data that is getting generated on our sites, and with our scale, if we have the right tech and product stack, the opportunity is huge. So I think what we have done is on tech and product side of things, we have advanced our contextual and behavioral data collection and insights capabilities, and through best in class segmentation and cohorting, we are able to offer and leverage these and target them for the benefit of advertisers.
So are you saying that, you know, this move will give rise to contextual advertising based on the content that a user is looking for?
So look, so I think, firstly, I think overall first party data would become the new backbone of digital advertising post cookie sunset world we get in. Right. So while let's say there will be multiple solutions people will take, for example, there are solutions being built by the key networks as well. Right. So we all of us would look to leverage that as well, especially on the client side solutions. But I think publishers who have capability of building their own first party data and leveraging their insights, they will be at a competitive advantage. Right.
So, if you can, because that is actually my last question. So, you know, I wanted to understand what kind of solutions are publishers creating from the first party data on their platforms?
So I think two parts to this. I think one is there will be, let's say, we are keen on exploring audience targeting through PPID, so publisher provider identifier at scale, and working closely with advertisers to integrate our first party data with advertiser first party data, enabling advertisers to leverage their first party data and integrate into our campaign. So essentially, one of the biggest breakthrough I think that possibly would happen is how do we combine first party data of publishers with that of advertiser? Like that's I think one key progress we are making, working towards it. For example, we are looking to integrate our SDKs with a native platform for occurrence-led targeting, for example, so that if a consumer jumps from a advertiser to our platform, the user journeys are sort of synced in, right? They aren't disjointed. So that's one of the solutions. Other, of course, is I think let's say if we are common, so we could use common user identifier either through direct integrations or via third-party ID consortiums, like so that does not depend on a third-party cookie. So that could be other alternate. Lastly, I feel contextual, etc., will play a very key role. So our ability to offer audience-based performance campaigns, control the frequency and positioning of ads on users, on various signed interactive data points, all these factors which we'll be able to offer as a publisher will go a long way in ensuring the seamless transition, as well as the rightful place for publishers like us in the post-cookie world.
I was reading about this entire thing before our session, and I came across this report that, you know, publishers could lose up to $10 billion in ad revenue when third-party cookies are disabled. And as per Google's own research, most publishers could lose 50 to 70% of their revenue if they don't reconfigure their approach. So what would be your last word on this? Because we have to close the session now.
I think my last word would be every challenge presents an opportunity, and this is an opportunity especially for players at scale like us. And I imagine with the kind of content we offer, content has the chance of becoming a new digital advertising currency in the cookieless world, right? So and that's where publishers have an advantage. So how do we leverage the strong ability of offering, let's say, unique user segments and a heavily contextual heavy contextual environment to showcase brands and products, right? That's something only as publishers we can do. So if we can get that act right, I think this is a clearly a sort of homecoming, I would say, for publishers. And lastly, I'll just add, I think bulk of our discussion was around leveraging first-party data for let's say, improving audience targeting for advertisement. I think not only first-party will help towards that, but also in personalization of content and UI, UX, and engagement. So I think this will also help us deliver a best-in-class user experience where every user journey will be personalized. So being able to build infinite user journeys where every part or every pixel of our sites will be personalized, that's the sort of future we are looking at.
Thank you, Puneet. Thank you so much for doing this. And, you know, from what I have understood is that going forward for most of these digital publishers, the first-party data and the content will start to play the role of new digital currency. So Did I get it right? Right.
Yeah, that's at least I think of. I'm sure everybody will have their own perspective.
Thank you, Mr. Jain, for joining us. We wish to have you again for a much longer session. This time we were totally pressed for time and we're already late. So thanks again. And I